When we counter with a problem on trusses, there are two methods of solving that. One is method of sections and another is method of joints. When we need to find forces in a member, in members which are very near to the extreme points, that is supports, for in that case we it usage of method of joints is beneficial. Like if we are going to find force in this member or this member or this member or this one or this or this one. But in the given problem, say here, he is asking to find the force in the member CE, which is here, which is away from the joint. In such cases where member is away from the either of the supports, in that cases it is preferred to use method of sections. Now let me, for your ease and understanding, let me spell out each and everything here. This is a truss with this point, this support named as A, here it is B, C, D, it is E, F, and this point is G. And here each, in the base, it is each section, each element, length is L, which whose value is 20 meters. Now, this F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, all these forces at these joints are downwards and the value is 2000 newtons. Now we need to find the force in the member CE. Options given are 1000, 2000, 3000 and 4000. We need to find the nearest among these four. Now how method of section works is, we will divide this total truss into two parts using a section, using a line or section, such that there are certain rules while dividing it such into two parts, such that we can apply the rules sigma fx equal to 0, sigma fy equal to 0, and sigma m, sigma moments about equals to about certain point, say for example C or A or B, whatever it is, certain point P, about certain point, that P can be anything like A or B or C, anywhere depending on that, in that plane it can be any point. So we can use this for one of the parts, and rules to follow while cutting this is, or sectioning this truss, is that section line should pass only through any three of the links. It should not pass more than three members, because when we are cutting it, say for example here this is like this member, this is a member, say for example we are cutting like this, here 1 2 3 4 four members are there. When we divide it, something we will get like this. So here force in this element, force in this element, force in this element, and force in this element. Four forces have to be found, four members, but we only have three equilibrium equations. So fourth one will be undetermined, any one of them will be undetermined. So it cannot be found, the answers cannot be found. So in order to find out the values, or for ease of calculations and for to make the solution possible, we should make this section passing through only three or less than three links. So we can cut it like this, so that we can somewhat get the divided parts as like this, and on other hand this will be the so see, I have divided this into two parts, this one into two parts, and this is one part and this is one part. So at this joint, this link is there, this total unified link where I am sectioned. After sectioning, this some we will look at it like this. So these are the forces. We assume that all the forces here are tensile in nature, so that if we get the answers as positive values for these forces, they are of course tensile. If they are opposite or negative, that means it is compressive. So that depends, that we get a positive value or negative value while solving using these equations. Anyhow, one more rule is, that means first rule is it should pass only through three members of the truss. Another rule is that section should, one of those three members must be the one for which we want to find the force. Those two rules we have to follow. Similarly, here we will do the same. So that is actually background of this method of sections. I'm not going to much detail, just trying to give you a brief idea how to solve the given problem. Now, CE we want, here we will divide it like this so that 1, 2 and 3 members are cut down. If we try to cut this truss in any other way, it will pass through 4 or more than 4 members. So we won't do that, we will cut these 3, BC, CE and EF, it will pass through like that. So on that, when we separate it out, I am drawing this only separated part here. I am separating instead of this links, say this link, I am separating it here. I am passing a section here at this point. That means when I put this part, I draw that part, free body diagram. When I say free body diagram, in places where I am removing the parts, there it should be replaced with the equivalent force or reaction. Now it is A, it is B, this is what part we get. But this is not complete free body diagram, this is just the truss part which is separated out. Now when I say free body diagram, I have to place all the forces here. These are reaction forces of the supports. These are the force, external forces at joints, and these will be the force members. Force, this is BC, so force FBC. This will be force on this part, on this link part, a force of, on this link part, cut part, there will be a force FBC, on this cut part, there will be a force FCE, and on this cut part, there will be a force FEF, force EF. Now, we don't want others, we only want FCE. We have a technique for reducing the time. Since we don't want all three and just want this thing, when we try to apply the equilibrium equation sigma m, that means resultant moment, since we assume that this total truss is in equilibrium under this force system. And when I say that every piece or every part of this system should be under equilibrium, then appropriately drawn with free body diagram. So I have drawn free body diagram here. So when I apply equilibrium equations, it should satisfy. Now out of all the equilibrium equations, I will try to apply that resultant moment about certain point is zero. Now I need to decide about which point. If I choose A here, about A, this force FBC is anyway passing through A, and FEF is also passing through A, that means they both will be negated, or they both will be neutralized. That means when I say sigma moments about A equal to 0, when I apply this equation of equilibrium, then what I need to do is FBC, force BC into distance between, perpendicular distance from point A onto this force vector FBC. Since it is already passing through that, the distance will be 0. Plus similarly FEF into, again the distance, already FEF vector is passing through A, that means there is no perpendicular distance between A and FEF. Why I am saying this? Because if this is a point and there is a force vector like this, then moment will be this force vector F into magnitude, I am saying force vector into this perpendicular distance, so F into R will be the moment about this point for this force vector. So that when we apply here, there is no R value for FBC and FEF when we take A as the moment center, but when we take FCE, we have distance of 20 plus 20, that is total 40 from A. We are taking anti-clockwise moments as positive. So about A, this FC is trying to rotate anti-clockwise. So it is okay, positive. Now there are few more forces, don't take it as direct, don't put zero, there are few more. Again, 2000 force is the downwards. This, that means about A, this 2000 newtons effect is, moment is downwards. 2000 means clockwise, that means negative moment. So 2000 into this length, that is 20. So since it is clockwise, 2000 into 20. Again, this also in clockwise, but distance is 40 meters, 20 plus 20, total 40. So minus 2000 into 40. Now, there are no more forces. 5000 is there, but that again, that is passing through A itself. That means there is no perpendicular distance between A and this 5000 force vector, that is reaction force vector. So this is what is the final equation, equal to 0. When we solve this, we get as FCE into 40 equal to, when we take that side, it will be 2000 into 60. Now cancel out 50 into 60, that is 3000 newtons. So FCE, the force in the link FCE is 3000 newtons. See, anyway, luckily he didn't ask whether it is tensile or compressive, but anyway, the nature is tensile. So that's fine. Now that is 3000. Now this is how we need to solve to find a force in truss member using method of sections. Thank you.